white, a blank page, or canvas. The challenge. Bring order to the whole through design. Composition. Balance. Light and harmony. I want you to look out at the water.
I feel foolish.
Why?
I hate this thing.
Then why wear it?
Why wear it? Everyone is wearing them.
Everyone.
You know they are.
Stand still, please.
I read they're even wearing them in America.
They are fighting the Indians in America, and you cannot read.
I can read. A little. Why did we have to get up so early?
The light.
Oh. What's the matter?
I hate this tree.
I thought you were drawing me.
I am. Just stand still.
I wish we could go sailing. I wouldn't go this early in the day, though.
Could you drop your head a little, please? Dot. If you wish to be a good model, you must learn to concentrate. Hold the pose.
Look out at the water. Thank you.
Where is that tree? Nurse? Nurse?
My God, she's everywhere.
Nurse!
What is it, madame?
The tree! Where is our tree?
What tree?
The tree we always sit near. Someone has moved it.
No one has moved it, madame. It is right over there. Come along.
Do not push me.
I am not pushing. I am helping.
You are pushing, and I do not need any help.
Yes, madame.
And this is not our tree.
Yes, madame.
I do not envy the nurse.
She can read.
They were talking about you at La Coupole.
Oh.
Saying strange things.
They have so little to speak of, they must speak of me.
Were you at the zoo, George? Drawing the monkey cage?
Not the monkey cage.
They said they saw you.
The monkey's dot, not the cage.
This is true? Why draw monkeys?
Nurse, what is that?
What, madame?
That. Off. In the distance.
They are making way for the exposition.
What exposition?
The international exposition. They are going to build a tower.
Another exposition.
They say it is going to be the tallest structure in the world.
Oh, foreigners. I am sick of foreigners.
More boats. More trees.
George, why is it you always get to sit in the shade while I have to stand in the sun? George? Hello, George? There is someone in this dress. A trickle of sweat. The back of the head. The always does this. Now the foot is dead. Sunday in the park with George, one more. The collar is damp, beginning to pinch. The bustle slipping, I won't budge one inch. Who was at the zoo, George? Who was at the zoo? The monkeys and who, George? The monkeys and who?
Don't move, please.
Artists are bizarre, fixed, cold. That's you, George, you're bizarre, fixed, cold. I like that in a man, fixed, cold. God, it's hot out here. Well, there are worse things than staring at the water on a Sunday. There are worse things than staring at the water as you're posing for a picture being painted by your lover in the middle of the summer on an island in the river on a Sunday. Petticoat's wet, which adds to the weight. The sun is blinding. All right, concentrate.
Eyes open, please.
Sunday in the park with George.
Look out at the water, not at me.
Sunday in the park with George. Concentrate, concentrate. And attention, not to say connection. Modeling's no profession. If you want instead, when you're dead, some more public and more permanent expression of affection. You want a painter, poet, sculptor, preferably marble, granite, bronze, durable. Something nice with swans that's durable forever. I love your beard, George. I love your size, George. But most, George, of all. But most of all, I love your. Of a stay right under the tit. No, don't give in, just lift the arm a bit.
Lift the arm, please.
Sunday in the park with George.
Bustle high, please.
Not even a nod, as if I were a tree. The ground could open, he would still say please. Never know with you, George. Who can know with you? The others I knew, George. Before we get through, I'll get to you too. God, I am so hot. Well, there are worse things than staring at the water on a Sunday. There are worse things than staring at the water as you're posing for a picture after sleeping on the ferry and getting up a 7 to go over to an strong today.
Almost finished.
I'd rather be in the studio, George.
I know.
They are out early today?
It is Sunday, madame.
That is what I mean, nurse. Young boys out swimming so early on a Sunday.
Well, it is awfully warm.
Hand me my parasol.
I am, madame.
Oh, no.
What?
Oh, look. Look, look who is over there.
So?
So, when he is around, you know who is likely to follow.
You have moved your arm.
George, I think they are spying on you. I really do.
Are you going to keep your head still?
You are here awfully early today.
Yeah, so are you.
And working on a Sunday.
Yeah.
It is a beautiful day.
It is too hot.
Do you think?
Where is my fan?
I have to go back now. You did not bring it today, madame.
Of course I brought it.
Perhaps we will see each other later.
Perhaps.
There it is over there.
That is my fan.
Well, I can use it, can I not? Oh. It was just lying there. What is all that commotion? Nurse, go see what those boys are doing.
You men!
Ah!
Oh! Oh, dear.
Oh, my.
Oh, my dear.
It has no presence.
No passion.
No life. It's neither pastoral nor lyrical.
You don't suppose that it's satirical?
Oh, yeah. Just density without intensity.
No life. Boys with their clothes off.
I must paint a factory next.
It's so mechanical.
Methodical.
It might be in some dreary socialistic periodical.
Good.
So drab, so cold.
And so controlled. No, no life. His touch is too deliberate somehow.
The dog.
These things get hung, and then they're gone.
Of course he's young, but getting on.
All mind, no heart, no life in his art.
No life in his life.
No.
Artist. What is his name?
What is his name?
I can never remember their names.
George! Out very early today.
Hello, Jules.
A lovely day.
I couldn't be out sketching today. It's too sunny.
Have you seen the painting yet?
Yes. I was just going to say, boys bathing, what a curious subject. We must speak.
I loved the dog.
I am pleased there was an independent exhibition. We must speak, really.
Enjoy the weather.
Yes. Good day.
That dress!
I hate them.
Jules is a fine painter.
I do not care. I hate them.
From?
We are waiting!
Yeah, madame, monsieur, at your service.
Thank you.
Began to do it.
What?
Oh, concentrate like you said.
You did very well.
Did I really?
Yes. I'll meet you back at the studio.
You are not coming?
Not now. Dot, we'll go to the Follies tonight. Bonjour.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Lovely morning, ladies.
Yes.
I have my pad and crayons today.
Oh, that not would be today. Lovely.
Why not today?
Too warm.
Yes, it is warm, but it won't take long.
Some
you may go about your business.
Some other day, monsieur.
It's George, mother. Yes. I guess we will all be back.
Taught me all about concentration. The art of being still, he said. I guess I did not learn it soon enough. George likes to be alone. Sometimes he will work all night long painting. We've thought about that. I need sleep. I love to dream. George doesn't need as much sleep as everyone else. And he never tells me his dreams. George has many secrets.
Order. Design. Composition. Tone. Form, symmetry, balance, more red, and a little more red, blue, 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 even, even, good, bum, 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 more red, more blue. A beer. More light. Color and light. There's only color and light. Yellow and white. Just blue and yellow and white. Look at the air, miss. See what I mean. No, look over there, miss. That's done with green. And joined with orange.
Nothing seems to fit me right. The less I wear, the more comfortable I feel. More rouge. George is very special. Maybe I'm just not special enough for him. If my legs were longer, if my bust was smaller, if my hands were graceful, if my waist was thinner, if my hips were flatter, if my voice was a walk, if I could dance in. I'd be in the Follies, I'd be in the cabaret. Woo! Gentlemen in dogs of hands, a linen fans would wait with flowers. I could make them wait for hours. Giddy young aristocrats in fancy flats would drink my health, and I would be as hard as nails. And they'd only want me more if I was a Folly girl. I wouldn't like it much. Married men and stupid boys, I having too much smoke and all that noise and all that color and light.
Aren't you proper today, miss? Your parasol so properly cocked, your bustle so perfectly upright. No doubt your chin rests at just the proper angle from your chest. And you, sir, your hat so black to you perhaps, so red to me.
And then the others worked at night.
So composed for a Sunday.
How do you work without the right, white light? Have you fathomed, George?
Red, orange, red, orange, orange. Pick a blue, pick a red, pick a orange. From the blue, green, circle on the violet diagonal. Diagonal, no, yellow, comma. Num, 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 num. Blue, still sitting, red, that perfume, blue, all night, blue, green, the window shut, that, sitting, dot, waiting, dot, getting fat, more yellow, dot, waiting to go out. No, George, finish the hat, have to finish the hat first, hat, hot in here. Sunday.
He sees you and he doesn't all at once.
Purple and white.
What's he thinking when he looks like this?
And red and purple and white.
What does he see sometimes not even blinking?
Look at this glade, girls. Your cool blue spot.
His eyes are dark and shiny.
Now stay in the shade, girls. It's getting hot.
Something cold and black.
It's getting orange.
But it's warm inside his eyes.
Hotter.
And it's soft inside his eyes. And he burns you with his eyes.
Look at her looking.
And you're studied like the light.
Forever with that mirror. What does she see? The round face. The tiny pout. The soft mouth. Creamy skin.
And you look inside the eyes.
The pink lips, the red cheeks.
And you catch him here and there.
Wide eyes studying the round face. The tiny pouncing all the parts and none of the whole. But the way she catches a light.
And you're drawn inside the eyes. My red dress or blue?
Red.
Aren't you going to clean up?
Why?
The Follies, George.
I have to finish the hat. Will she yell or stay silent? Go without me or sulk in the corner? Will she be in the bed when the hat and the grass and the parasol have finally found their way to green? Do I care? To blue?
Yes.
To soft? What should I do? Red.
Thank you.
water looks different on Sunday.
It is the same water that you boat on all week.
It looks different from the park.
You prefer watching the boats to the people promenading.
People all dressed up in their Sunday best, pretending. Sunday's just another day. I wear what I always wear, and I don't have to worry.
Worry?
Hey, leave me alone, dressed like this. No one comes near.
Look who's over there. Dot!
Who is she with?
It looks like Louis the Baker.
Well, how did Dot get to be with Louis?
She knows how to make dough rise.
There is that woman.
Who is she with?
Looks like the baker.
Moving up, I suppose.
The artist is more handsome.
You cannot eat paintings, my dear. Not when there's bread in the oven.
They say he is working on an enormous canvas.
I heard somewhere he's painting little specks.
You heard it from me. A large canvas of specks, really.
Look at him, drawing a slovenly boatman.
I think he's trying to play with life.
What next?
A monkey cage, they say.
Sunday hypocrites, that's what they are. Muttering and murmuring about this one and that one. I'll take my old dog for company any day. A dog knows his place, respects your privacy, makes no demands, right, Spot?
They say that George has another woman.
I'm not surprised.
They said George only lives with tramps.
I'm not surprised.
They say he prowls through the streets in his top hat after midnight.
No.
And stands there staring up at the lamps.
I'm not surprised.
Artists are so crazy.
Those girls are noisy.
Yes, madame.
That man is famous.
Yes, madame.
That man is filthy.
Your son seems to find him interesting.
That man's deluded.
Artists are so crazy.
Artists are so peculiar.
Monkeys?
Overprivileged women complaining. Silly little simpering shop girls. Condescending artists observing. Perceiving. Well, screw them.
Artists are so
What do you do with those drawings, anyway?
That's George.
There is a move on to include his work in the next group show.
Never.
I agree. I agree.
He draws anyone.
Old boatman. Peculiar man. Like his father, I said.
I said so first. Lesson number 8. Pronouns. Pronouns. What is a pronoun? A pronoun is the word used in the place of a noun. Do you recall what a noun is? Certainly I recall. Example. Charles has a book. Marie wants Charles' book. Not Marie again. Marie wants his book. Fill in the blanks. Charles ran with Marie's ball. Charles ran with H-E-R ball. Get the ball back, Marie.
Children should not go unattended.
She is very young to be alone.
I do not like what I see today, nurse.
What do you see?
Lack of discipline.
Oh.
Not the right direction at all.
Fools rowing. You call that recreation?
Almost finished.
Get away from that log!
That was hardly necessary.
Well, how do you know what's necessary, huh?
Who are you with your fancy pad and your crayons? You call that work? You smug. You're goddamn holier than thou, shitty little men in your fancy clothes. You're born with pens and pencils, not bricks.
Ooh. You don't know.
What are you going to do now that you have no one to draw?
Shh, don't talk to him.
I am drawing his dog.
His dog?
Honestly.
I have already sketched you, ladies.
What?
You have?
Oh, I do not believe you.
What?
A few Sundays ago.
But we never sat for you.
I studied you from afar.
No.
Where were you?
I want to see.
Someday you shall.
When?
Today.
Well, he did not so much as ask.
No respect for a person's privacy.
I would not sit for him anyway.
Probably that's why he did not ask.
Good afternoon.
Hello.
Lesson number 8.
Yes, I am. Pronouns. My writing is improving. I even keep notes in the back of the book.
Good for you.
How is your painting coming along?
Slowly.
Do you find you're getting more work done now that you have fewer distractions in the studio?
It has been quiet there.
Dot, I made your favorite.
Good day.
Cream puffs.
If the head were smaller, if the tail were longer, if we faced the water, if the paws were hidden, if the neck was darker, if the back was curved, more like the parasol. Bum 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 bum. More shade. More tail. More grass. Would you like some more grass?
Roof! Roof! Flanks! The week has been roof! When you're stuck for life on a garbage scow, only 40 feet long from stern to prow, and a crackpot in the bow, wow, roof! The planks are roof, and the wind is roof, and the master's drunk and mean, and roof, roof! With the fish and scum and planks and ballast, the nose gets numb and the paws get calloused. And with splinters in your ass, you look forward to the grass on Sunday. The day of hoof. Hoof, hoof, hoof. Hoof. The grass needs to be thicker. Perhaps a few weeds and some ants, if you would. I love fresh ants. Roaming around on Sunday, poking among the roots and rocks. Nose to the ground on Sunday, studying all the shoes and socks. Everything's worth it Sunday, the day off. Bits of pastry, piece of chicken. Here's a handkerchief that somebody was sick in. There's a thistle, that's a shallot. That's a dripping from the loony with the pallet. Just passed. Yep, everything's worth it Sunday.
day off. Yep, stuck all week on a lady's lap. Nothing to do but yawn and nap. Can you blame me if I yap?
Nope.
There's only so much attention a dog can take. Being alone on Sunday, rolling around in mud and dirt.
Begging a bone on Sunday, settling for a spoiled dessert.
Everything's worth it
someday.
The day off.
Something fuzzy.
Something furry.
Something pink that someone tore off in a hurry.
What's the muddle in the middle?
What's the puddle where the poodle did the piddle?
Taking the day on Sunday, now that the dreary week is dead. Getting away on Sunday brightens the dreary week ahead. Everyone's on display on Sunday,
the day off.
Bonnet flapping, bustle sliding, like a rocking horse that nobody's been riding. There's a daisy and some clover, and that interesting fellow looking over.
One day is much like any other, listening to her snap and the drone. Still, Sunday with someone's dotty mother is better than Sunday with your own. Mothers may drone, mothers may whine, tending to his though is perfectly fine. It pays for the nurse that is tending to mine on Sunday, my day off.
This is just ridiculous.
Oh, why shouldn't we fish?
No one will notice us anyway.
Look.
Where?
Soldiers.
Alone.
What did I tell you?
Well, they'll never talk to us if we fish. Why don't we go tell them?
Shh. It's a beautiful day for fishing.
What do you think? I like the one in the light hat.
Rita!
Oh, no.
Rita!
Not now, Louise.
I want to play.
Go away, Louise. We are not working today.
Let's go throw stones at the ducks.
Louise, do not throw stones at the ducks.
Why not?
You know why not, and you know this is our day off, so go find your mother and throw some stones at her, why don't you?
Franz! Franz!
I'm selling...
Good, go!
Mama!
Relax!
Yeah, relax.
Second bottle!
Ah, she looks for me.
He is bursting to go.
Near the fountain.
I could let him.
How to manage it?
No. You know, Franz.
Huh?
I believe that artist is drawing us.
Who?
Monsieur's friend.
Monsieur would never think to draw us. We are only people he looks down upon. I should have been an artist. I was never intended for work.
Artists work, Franz. I believe they work very hard.
Work? We work. We serve their food. We carve their meat. We tend to their house. We polish their silverware.
The food we serve, we also eat.
For then we rush, wash and brush, wipe and vex.
Franz, relax.
While he creates, we scrape their plates. Und das der knickknacks, hundreds to the shelf. Work is what you do for others, Liebchen. Art is what you do for yourself.
Working on Sunday, again? You should give yourself a day off.
Why?
You must need time to replenish. Or does your well never run dry? Drawing my servants. Certainly, George, you could find more colorful subjects.
Who should I be sketching?
How about that pretty friend of yours? Now, Why did I see her arm in arm with the baker today? She is a pretty subject.
Yes.
Your life needs spice, George. Go to some parties. That is where you will meet prospective buyers, have some fun. The work is bound to reflect the
fact. You don't like my work, do you, Jules?
I did once.
You find it too tight.
People are talking about your work. You have your admirers.
I am using a different brush stroke.
Always changing. Why keep changing?
Because I do not paint for your approval.
And I suppose that is why I like you. Good to see you, George.
Jules, I would like you to come to the studio sometime, see the new work.
For my approval?
No, for your opinion.
Very well.
You and me, pal, we're the loonies. Did you know that? Bet you didn't know that. 'Cause we tell them the truth. Who are you drawing? Who the hell you think you're drawing? Me? You don't know me. Go on drawing, since you're drawing only what you want to see. Anyway, one eye, no illusion that you get with two. One for what is true, one for what suits you. Deny your wrong conclusion, all you artists do. I see what is true. Sitting there looking everybody up and down, studying every move like you see something different, like your eyes no more. You and me, pal, we're society's fault.
Taking the day on Sunday, after all the week instead. Getting away on Sunday, like the very week ahead. Leaving the city pressure behind you. All for the air is fresher. Red, green, blue, blind you.
Hello, George. Where did you go, George? I know you're near, George. I caught your eyes, George. I want your ear, George. I have a surprise, George. Everybody loves Louis. Louis, simple and kind. Everybody loves Louis. Louis, lovable.
Louis!
Seems we never know, do we? Who we're going to find? And Louis the baker is not what I had in mind. But Louis's really an artist. Louis's cakes are an art. Louis isn't the smartest. Louis's popular. Everybody loves Louis. Louis bakes from the heart. The bread, George. I mean the bread, George. And then in bed, George. I mean he needs me. I mean like dog, George. Hello, George. Louis always so pleasant. Louis always so fair. Louis makes you feel present. Louis generous. That's the thing about Louis. Louis always is there. Louis' thoughts are not hard to follow. Louis' art is not hard to swallow.
Louis.
Not that Louis' perfection, that's what makes him ideal. Hardly anything worth objection. Louis drinks a bit, Louis blinks, Louis makes a connection. That's the thing that you feel. We lose things, and then we choose things, and there are there are Georges. Well, Louis and George. But George has George. And I need someone. Everybody loves Louis, him as well as his cakes. Everybody loves Louis, me included. George. Not afraid to be gooey, Louis sells what he makes. Everybody gets along with him. That's the trouble. Nothing's wrong with him. Louis has to beg his way, George can only beg his.
Paris looks nothing like the paintings.
I know.
I don't see any passion, do you?
None.
The French are so placid.
I don't think they have much style either.
What's all the carrying on back home? Delicious pastries, though.
Excellent.
Looking at those boats over there makes me think about our return voyage.
I long to be back home.
You do?
How soon could we leave?
Well, you're that anxious to leave. Oh, but peaches, we just arrived.
I know.
Well, I don't like it here either. We'll go right back to that hotel and I'll book passage for the end of the week. We'll go to the galleries this afternoon and be on our way home.
I am so relieved. I will miss these pastries, though.
We'll take a baker with us, too.
Wonderful.
I should try using that pole.
It won't make any difference.
Oh!
What's wrong?
Just sit there.
May we be of some service, madame?
Oh, mademoiselle. Oh,
she has a fetish.
She knows.
Allow me.
But it tugged so.
There's no sign of a fish here.
Oh, me. My name is Celeste. Oh, this is my friend.
Celeste.
Well, do you have a name?
I beg your pardon. Napoleon. Some people feel I should change it.
No.
And your friend?
Yes, he is my friend.
He's very quiet.
Yes, actually, he is. He lost his hearing during combat exercises.
Oh, what a shame.
He can't speak either.
How dreadful.
We have become very close, though.
So I see.
Mademoiselles, I and my friend, we are but soldiers. Passing the time in between wars for weeks at an end.
Both of them are perfect.
You can have the other.
I don't want the other.
I don't want the other either.
And after a week spent mostly indoors with nothing but soldiers, ladies, I and my friend, trust we will not offend, which we never intend, by suggesting we spend this magnificent Sunday.
On Sunday.
With you and your friend.
The one on the right's an awful bore.
He's been in a war.
We may get a meal and we might get more. It's certainly fine for
Sunday.
It's certainly fine for
Sunday.
It's certainly fine for
Sunday.
Mademoiselles, you and me, pal. Second bottle, ah, she looks for me. Bonnet flapping, yapping, roof, chicken, pastry. Yes, she looks for me. Let her look for me to tell me why she left me, as I always knew she would. I had thought she understood. They have never understood, and no reason that they should. But if anybody could, finishing the hat. How you have to finish the hat. How you watch the rest of the world from a window while you finish the hat. Mapping out a sky. What you feel like planning a sky. What you feel when voices that come through the window go until they distance and die. Until there's nothing but sky. And how you're always turning back too late from the grass or the stick or the dog or the light. How the kind of woman willing to wait, not the kind that you want to find waiting to return you to the night. Dizzy from the hat. Coming from the hat. Studying the hat. Entering the world of the hat. Reaching through the world of the hat like a window, back to this one from that. Studying a face, stepping back to look at a face, leaves a little space in the way like a window, but to see, it's the only way to see. And when the woman that you wanted goes, you can say to yourself, well, I give what I give. But the woman who won't wait for you knows that however you live, there's a part of you always standing by, mapping out the sky. Finishing a hat. Starting on a hat. Finishing a hat. Look, I made a hat. Well, there never was a hat.
Sir, we are lost.
Huh?
Let me try, Daddy. We are alien here.
Huh?
Unable to find passage off island.
Why don't you just walk into the water till your lungs fill up and you die?
Oh. Well, oh, I detest these people.
Isn't that the baker?
Yes, it is.
Where is that tree? Nurse! Nurse!
If I don't change my mind again. And you?
2 more months.
You cannot change your mind.
Nor do I want to. Is it going to be exhibited?
I'm not sure. Jules is coming over to look at it any minute, in fact.
Oh, I hope you don't mind my coming.
What is it that you want, Dot?
George, I would like my painting.
Your painting?
The one of me powdering?
I didn't know that it was yours.
You said once I could have it.
In my sleep.
I want something to remember you by.
You don't have enough now?
I want the painting, too.
I understand that you and Louis are getting married.
Yes.
He must love you very much to take you in that condition.
He does.
I didn't think you would go through with it. I did not think that was what you really wanted.
I don't think I can have what I really want. Louis is what I think I need.
Yes, Louis will take you to the Follies, correct?
George, I didn't
George?
Come to...
Back here, Jules!
I will go.
Don't leave, please.
There you are. I brought Yvonne along.
May I take a peek?
I will wait in the other room.
Oh, I hope we are not interrupting you.
It is so large. How can you get any perspective? And this light
Stand is... Stand here.
Extraordinary. Excuse me. Talk of painting bores me. It is difficult to escape it when you are with an artist. I do not know how you can walk up all those steps in your condition. I remember when I had Louise. I could never be on my feet for long periods of time. Certainly could never navigate steps.
Did someone carry you around?
Why are you so cool to me?
Maybe I don't like you.
Whatever have I done to make you feel that way?
Whatever have I done? Perhaps it is the way you speak. What are you really doing here?
You know why we are here, so Jules can look at George's work.
I do not understand why George invites you. He knows you do not like his painting.
That is not entirely true. Jules has great respect for George, and he has encouraged him since they were in school.
That is not what I hear. Jules is jealous of George now.
Well... jealousy is a form of flattery, is it not? I have been jealous of you on occasion. When I have seen George drawing you in the park, Jules has seldom sketched me.
You are his wife.
Too flat, too angular.
Modeling is hard work. You wouldn't like it anyway.
It is worth it, don't you think?
Sometimes.
Has your life changed much now that you are with the baker?
I suppose. He enjoys caring for me.
Oh, you are very lucky. I suppose Jules cares, but there are times when he just does not know that Louise and I are there. And George always seems so oblivious to everyone. Jules says that is what is wrong with his painting. Too obsessive. You have to have a life. Don't you agree?
George, I do not know what to say. What is this?
What is the dominant color, the flower on the hat?
Is this a school exam, George?
What is that color?
Violet.
See. Red and blue. Your eye made the violet.
So?
So, your eye is perceiving both red and blue and violet. Only 11 colors. No black, divided, not mixed on the palette, mixed by the eye. Can't you see the shimmering?
George,
science, Jules. Fixed laws for color, like music.
You are a painter, not a scientist. You cannot even see these faces.
I am not painting faces.
George, I have touted your work in the past, and now you are embarrassing me. People are talking about this.
Why should I paint like you or anybody else? I am trying to get through to something new, something that is my own.
And I'm trying to understand.
And I want you to understand. Look at the canvas, Jules. Really look at it.
George, let us get to the point. You have invited me here because you want me to try to get this included in the next group show.
It will be finished soon. I want it to be seen.
Jules, I'm sorry to interrupt, but you know we must be going. We have another engagement.
Yes.
Thank you, George.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for coming.
I will give the matter some thought.
He does not like you. He does not understand or appreciate you. He can only see you as everyone else does, afraid to take you apart and put you back together again for himself. But we will not let anyone deter us, will we? Bum, 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 bum.
George!
Excuse me. Speaking with Jules.
George,
about
you
the painting.
Asked me to stay, and then
well,
you forget that
brushes.
I am even
I
here.
I do not believe that he even looked at the painting.
George, I have something to tell you.
Yes, now about your painting.
I may be going away to America.
Alone?
Of course not. With Louis, he has work.
When?
After the baby arrives.
You will not like it there.
How do you know?
I have read about America. Why are you telling me this? First, you ask for a painting that is not yours. And then you tell me this. I have work to do.
Yes, George, run to your work. Hide behind your painting. I have come to tell you I am leaving because I thought you might care to know. Foolish of me, because you care about nothing.
I care about many things.
Things, not people.
People, too. I cannot divide my feelings up as neatly as you, and I am not hiding behind my
what
canvas. I am living in
yourself.
I care for this painting. You will be in
I
this painting.
I have something you can use.
I had thought you understood.
It's because I understand that I left, that I
There's
am leaving.
There's nothing I can say, is there?
Yes, George, there is. You could tell me not to go. Say it to me. Tell me not to go. Tell me that you're hurt. Tell me you're relieved. Tell me that you're bored. Anything. But don't assume I know. Tell me what you feel.
What I feel. You know exactly how I feel. Why do you insist you must hear the words when you know I cannot give you words? Not
the ones you need. There's nothing to say. I cannot be what you want.
What do you want,
I needed
George?
You and you left.
There was no room for
you. You will
me.
Not accept who I am. I am what I do, which you knew, which you always knew, which I thought you were a part of.
Now you are complete, George. You are your own.
We do not belong together.
You are complete, George. You all alone. I am unfinished. I am diminished.
With or without you, we do not belong together. And we should have belonged together.
What made it so right together
is what made it all wrong.
No one is you, George, there we agree. But others will do, George. No one is you, and no one can be. But no one is me, George.
No one is me, we do not belong. Have a mission to see. Now I have one too,
George.
And we should have belonged.
I remember when you were a little boy, you would rise up early on a Sunday morning and go for a swim.
I do not know how to swim.
The boys would come by the house to get you.
I've always been petrified of the water.
And your father would walk you all to the banks of the Seine.
Father was never faithful to us.
And he would give you boys careful instruction, telling you just how far to swim out.
And he certainly never instructed.
Now look across there, in the distance. All those beautiful trees cut down for a foolish tower.
I don't think there were ever trees over there.
How I loved the view from here. Changing.
I'm quite certain that was an open field.
It keeps changing.
I used to play there as a child.
I see towers where there were trees. Going all the stillness, the solitude, Georgie.
Are beautiful, Mother. all trees, all towers beautiful, that tower beautiful, mother, see a perfect tree. Pretty isn't beautiful, mother. Pretty is what changes, what the eye arranges, is what is beautiful. I'm changing, you're changing. I'll draw up now before we fade, mother.
It keeps melting before our eyes.
Watch while I revise the world.
Changing as we see.
I'm glad to be free of him.
Friends can be confining.
He never understood my moods.
She only thought of herself.
It felt as if I had this burden at my side.
I do not understand.
She never really cared for me.
We had very different tastes.
She had no taste.
Yes, she did seem rather pushy.
Oh, very. And he was so odd.
He is not odd.
No. I didn't really mean odd.
You better not let me get my hands on you, you little toad. Stop that!
Are we ever gonna get home?
You are blocking my light.
Marie and I came to watch.
Marie. You know, I do not like anyone staring over my shoulder.
Yes. I know. George, we are about to leave for America. I have come to ask for the painting of me powdering again. I would like to take it with me.
Oh, I have repainted it.
What?
Another model.
You knew I wanted it.
Perhaps if you had remained still.
Perhaps if you would look up from your pad. What is wrong with you, George? Can you not even look at your own child?
She is not my child. Louis is her father.
Louis is not her father.
Louis is her father now. Louis will be a loving and attentive father. I cannot, because I cannot look up from my pad. Dot. I am sorry.
I worry about you, George.
Could you turn slightly toward me, please?
No future in dreaming.
Drop the head a little, please.
I worry about you and that woman, too.
I have another woman in my life now.
They're all the same woman.
Variations on a theme.
You always drifted as a child.
Shadows are too heavy.
You were always in some other place, seeing something no one else could see.
Soft the light.
We tried to get through to you, George. Really, we did.
Connect, George. Connect.
Are you certain you wish to do this?
Of course. We just have to find a quiet spot. I've wanted to do it outside for a long time.
Franz would kill you.
Is he in the park?
I am not certain.
Oh, well, perhaps some other day would be better.
Some other day? Always some other day. Perhaps you don't really wish to.
I do. I love tall grass.
Tall grass. You wouldn't toy with my affections, would you?
No, certainly not, but
I see a quiet spot over there.
Over there? But there are people in that grove. Bonjour.
Do you suppose there is a violation being perpetrated by that man?
What?
There is something in the air today.
Oh, being alone is nothing new to me.
Oh, look. Look who is watching.
Sunday is such a bore. I would almost rather be in the shop. Do you like your work? I hate mine.
I do not care if she never speaks to me again.
She won't.
Franz! Oh, Franz, have you seen Louise?
Nein, madam.
But I thought Frieda was going to care for her today.
But it's Sunday.
What of it?
It's our day off.
Oh, but I have lost my little girl.
Let's go say hello to Celeste.
But I do not wish to speak with her.
Come, it'll be fun. Oh.
Louise, where have you been, young lady?
With Frieda.
There, you see.
Frieda?
And with Father.
Your father is in the studio.
No, he's not. He's with Frieda. I saw them.
Where?
Over there. Hmm? Tonguing.
Where?
No!
What have you been doing? I want to get something to my family. My mother's work.
Design. Tension. Balance.
I'm alone.
of light and dark and parasols. Bum, 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 bum.
People strolling through the trees.
Hot up here.
It's hot and it's monotonous.
I want my glasses.
This is not my good profile.
Nobody can even see my profile.
I hate this dress. Soldiers have forgotten us.
The boatman Schwitz says,
I am completely out of proportion.
These helmets weigh a lot on us.
This tree is blocking my view.
I can't see anything.
Why are they complaining? It could have been raining.
I hate these people.
It's hot up here, a lot up here. It's hot up here forever. A lot of fun. It's not up here. It's hot up here, no matter what. There's not a breath of air up here, and they're up here forever. It's not my fault. I got up here. I got up here. I am so hot up here.
Darling, don't clutch Mother's hand quite so tightly. Thank you. It's hot up here.
At least you have a parasol.
Well, look who's talking, sitting in the shade.
I trust my cigar is not bothering you. Unfortunately, it never goes out. You have excellent concentration.
It's good to be together again.
See, I told you they were odd.
Well, he took my glasses.
You've been eating some sticky.
I put on rouge today, too.
Don't you ever take a bath?
Just hand me my pen.
I can't.
At least the brat is with her mother.
I heard that.
Do you like tall grass?
No.
Watch your animals.
I hate these people.
It's hot up here and strange up here. No change up here forever. But still it is a while it is. And God, it is so hot.
I like the one in the light hat.
Hello, George. I do not wish to be remembered like this, George. With them, George, my ham, George. 3 inches off the ground, and then this monkey and these people, George. They'll argue till they fade and whisper things and grunt. But thank you for the shade and putting me in front. Yes, thank you, George, for that. And for the hat.
It's hot up here. It's hot and it's monotonous.
I want my glasses.
This is not my good profile.
I hate this dress.
It's hot up here.
The soldiers have forgotten us.
It's hot and it's monotonous.
It's good to be together again.
You don't like to talk to me. And for the moment you're fading, it's very degrading. And God, I am so hot. Well, there are worse things than sweating by a river on a Sunday. There are worse things than sweating by a river.
Wedding and a picture that was painted by a genius.
And you know that you're immortal.
And you'll always be remembered.
Even if they never see you.
And you're listening to drivel.
And you're part of your companion.
And you're about to see me selling.
And you're born beyond endurance.
And the baby has no diapers.
I'm not.
And you are out of all proportion.
And I hate being paid.
You forget a breeze up here. And she's up here forever. You cannot run amok up here. You're stuck up here in this cabot. Perspectives don't make sense up here. It's tense up here forever. The outward show of bliss up here is disappearing dot by dot. And it's
it is hard to believe.
Yes.
It seems like only yesterday we were posing for him.
We never posed for him.
We certainly did. We are in a painting.
Well, it isn't just that he asked
us to. Just keep quiet! I hardly knew the man. I would spend my Sundays here and I would see him sketching, so I was surprised when he stopped showing up. Of course, I didn't notice right away, but one day I realized something was different. Like a flash of light right through me, the way that man would stare at you when he sketched. I knew he was no longer.
I'm going to be a painter when I grow up.
If you live.
Honestly.
Keep your mouth shut.
It is my mouth and I'll do as I please.
Quiet. George was a gentleman.
Soft-spoken.
And a far superior artist to Monsieur.
He had beautiful eyes.
Yeah. Beautiful eyes.
Yeah. Well, eyes that captured beauty.
Yeah. He chose his subjects well.
I was in Charleston when I heard. At first, I was surprised by the news, almost relieved, in fact. Perhaps I knew this is how it would end. Perhaps we both knew.
A parent wants to die first. But George was always off and running, and I was never able to keep up with him. No one knew he was ill until the very last days. I offered to care for him, but he would let no one near, not even her.
George had great promise as a painter. It really is a shame his career was ended so abruptly. He had an unusual flair for color and light,
and his work was not as mechanical as some have suggested. I liked George. He was dedicated to his work, seldom did anything but work, and I am proud to have counted him among my friends.
George stopped me once in the park. It was the only time I had ever spoken to him outside the company of jewels. He stared at my jacket for a few moments, then muttered something about beautiful colors and just walked on. I rather fancied George. Well, most of the women did.
They all wanted him and hated him at the same time. They wanted to be painted, splashed on some fancy salon wall. But they hated him, too. Hated him because he only spoke when he absolutely had to. Most of all, they hated him because they knew he would always be around.
Ladies and gentlemen, in 1983, I was commissioned by this museum to create an art piece commemorating Georges Seurat's painting, A Sunday Afternoon on the Island of La Grande, Jatte. My latest chromolume stands before you now, the seventh in a continuing series. Because I have a special association to this painting, the museum director, Robert Greenberg, suggested I assemble a short presentation to precede the activation of my latest invention. I have brought my grandmother along to give me a hand, my grandmother Marie.
I was born in Paris, France, 98 years ago. My grandson, George.
I was born in Lodi, New Jersey, 32 years ago.
My mother was married to Louis, a baker. They left France when I was an infant to travel to Charleston, South Carolina.
Georges Seurat.
Born December 2nd, 1859.
It was through his mother that the future artist was introduced to the lower class Parisian parks. Seurat received a classical training at the Beaux-Arts.
Like his father, he was not an easy man to know.
He lived in an age when science was gaining influence over romantic principles.
He worked very hard.
His first painting at the age of 24, Bathing at Agnières, was rejected by the Salon, but was shown by the group of independent artists.
They hung it over the refreshment stand. Wasn't that awful?
On Ascension Day, 1884, he began to work on his second major painting, A Sunday Afternoon on the Island of La Grande Jatte. He was to work 2 years on this painting.
He always knew where he was going before he picked up a paintbrush.
He denied conventional perspective and conventional space.
He was unconventional in his lifestyle as well. So was I. You know, I was a Floridora girl for a short
Marie.
Time. When I left Charleston
Marie.
And before I was
Marie.
Married to my first husband.
The film is running. Huh.
They hung it over the refreshment stand.
Having studied scientific findings on color, he developed a new style of painting. He found by painting tiny particles color next to color that at a certain distance, the eye would fuse the specks optically, giving them greater intensity than any mixed pigments. He wanted to paint with color.
He wanted to paint With colored lights.
Beams of colored light, he hoped.
It was shown at the eighth and last Impressionist exhibition.
Monet, Renoir, and Sisley withdrew their submissions because of his painting.
They placed it in a small room off to the side of the main hall, too dark for the painting to truly be seen.
The painting was ridiculed by most, but there were also a handful of believers in his work.
He went on to paint six more major paintings before his sudden death at the age of 31. He never sold a painting in his lifetime.
On this occasion, I present my latest chromolum.
Number 7.
Which pays homage to La Grande Jatte and to my grandmother Marie. The score for this presentation has been composed by Naomi Eisen.
George begins to activate.
Don't read that part, Grandmother.
Don't read this.
Robert Greenberg?
Yes, just a minute, George. It's the regulator, George.
My apologies, ladies and gentlemen. For precise synchronization of all the visual elements, I have installed a new state-of-the-art Japanese microcomputer, which controls the voltage regulator. I think that the surge from the musical equipment has created an electrical short, and, unfortunately, no electricity, no art. If you just give us a moment, we can bypass the regulator and then we'll be back in business, all right? One second. Let's talk to it for a second. Don't pull it over. Don't do anything. Just put the screw
down. I'm very sorry, ladies and gentlemen. We seem to be having a little electrical difficulty.
There's no juice.
You must realize this is the first time we've had a collaboration like this at the museum, and it's offered some extraordinary challenges to us here. Now, I do hope to see all of you at the reception and dinner following this presentation. It will be right down the hall in the main gallery where the painting hangs. And we have a very special treat for you. As I am sure you have noticed, in order to raise additional funds, we have chosen to sell the air rights to the museum. And some of the 27 flights of condominiums which stand above us now will be open for your inspection after dinner. You may even wish to become one of our permanent neighbors.
Okay, we're ready.
In any case,
Bob.
I'd...
Bob. Ready to go.
Oh, well.
You hear me now?
Proceed.
Terrific.
Proceed.
Take it out. Grandma, continue.
When I was young, Mother loved telling me tales of her life in France, and of her work as an artist's model.
Her mother showed her this great painting and pointed to this woman and said that it was she.
And she pointed to a couple in the back. They were holding an infant child. And she said, that was me.
Shortly before my great-grandmother's death, she spoke of her association with the artist of this painting. She told Marie that Seurat was her real father.
I was shocked.
My parents never believed this story. After all, there was no proof.
My mother gave me this small red notebook.
Marie?
Oh, George, I wanted to bring the book and show it. In the back are notes about his great-grandfather, the artist.
Actually, this book is really just a grammar book in the handwriting of a child. And though there are notes in the back which mention Georges, they could be referring to anyone.
But but they do not.
I do not know that there is any validity to this story.
Of course there is validity. He has to have everything spelled out for him.
The facts are sketchy and the tales are many. I would now like to invite you into my Sunday Island of Light. It will be on exhibition here in the upstairs gallery until November 30th. I can't say that I understand what that light machine has to do with this painting.
Darling, it's a theme and variation.
Oh, theme and variation.
Times change so quickly.
Oh, Lord knows.
That's the challenge of our work. You never know what movement is going to hit next, which artist to embrace.
I thought it went very well, except for that electrical screw-up. What did you guys think?
Terrible.
Terrific.
I mean, I don't understand completely.
I'm not surprised.
But he combines all these different trends.
I'm not surprised.
You can't divide our today into categories neatly. Huh? What matters is the means, not the end.
I'm not surprised. That is the state of the art, my dear. That is the state of the art.
It's not enough knowing good from rotten.
You're telling me.
When something new pops up every day.
You're telling me.
It's only new, though, for now.
Nouveau.
But yesterday's forgotten.
And tomorrow is already passé.
There's no surprise.
That is the state of the art, my friend. That is the state of the art.
He's an original.
Was.
I like the images.
Some.
Come on, you had your moment. Now it's George's turn.
It's George's turn. I wasn't talking turns. I'm talking art. But is it really new?
Hello.
His own collaborator.
Oh, yes.
It's all promotion, but then that is the state of the art, isn't it?
Well,
art isn't easy.
Even when you have amassed it,
fighting for prizes.
No one can be an oracle.
Art isn't easy.
Suddenly, you're past it.
Compromises.
Art isn't easy. Art isn't easy. Any way you look at it.
Here's George now. Oh, hello, George.
All right, George. As long as it's your night, George. You know what's in the room, George. Another chromaloom, George. It's time to get to work.
George, look, all these lovely people in front of our painting.
George, I'd like you to meet one of our board members. This is Harriet Pauley.
Oh, what a pleasure. And this is my friend, Billy Webster.
How are you doing? Hi, how are you? Nice to meet you.
Well, I'll just leave you three to chat.
Harriet was so impressed by your presentation.
This is the third piece of yours I've seen. They're getting so large.
What heading does your work fall under?
Most people think of it as sculpture.
Sculpture?
I'd like to think of myself as an inventor as well as a sculptor.
It's so unconventional for sculpture.
Say cheese, George. And put them at their ease, George. You're up on the trapeze, George. Machines don't grow on trees, George. Start putting it together.
I bet your great-grandfather would be very proud.
Oh, yes, he would have loved this evening.
How do you know?
I just know I'm like that.
Hi, I'm Harriet Pauling.
Billy Webster.
How do you do? This is Elaine, George's former wife.
Hello.
Elaine is such a darling. I always think of her as my granddaughter. I'm so happy these children have remained close, though. Isn't that nice?
Yes. You know, Harriet has just gone through a rather messy divorce. And
Bill,
the two...
what a fascinating family you have.
Many people say that. You know, we're going to France next month to visit the island where the painting was painted. And George is going to bring the Lomachrome.
Chromalume. I've been invited by the government to do a presentation of the machine on the island.
George has never been to France.
Art isn't easy, even when you're hot.
Are these inventions of yours one of a kind?
Financing art is easy, yes. Financing it is not.
I take a year to make.
A vision's just a vision if it's only in your head.
The minute he finishes one, he starts raising money for the next one.
No one gets to see it. It's as good as
work,
dead.
Work.
It has to come to light. I put the names of my contributors on the side of each machine.
Some very impressive people.
Well, we must speak further. My family has a foundation, and we're always looking for new projects.
Bit by bit, putting it together.
Family is all you have.
Piece by piece, only way to make a work of art. Every moment makes a contribution. Every little detail plays a part. Having the vision's no solution. Everything depends on execution. Putting it together. That's what counts.
Actually, the board of the foundation is meeting next week.
Ounce by ounce, putting it together.
You'll come to lunch.
Small amounts, adding them to make a work of art. First of all, you need a good foundation. Otherwise, it's risky from the start. Takes a little cocktail conversation, but without the proper preparation. Having just a vision's no solution. Everything depends on execution. The art of making art is putting it together. Bit by bit.
Well, we have been hearing about you for quite some time. We really haven't met. Charles Redmond, County Museum of Texas.
How do you do?
It's a pleasure to meet you, George. Your work is just tremendous. I hate to bring up business during a social occasion, but I wanted you to know we are in the process of giving out some very sizable commissions.
You're not going to steal him away, are you?
Link by link, making the connections. Drink by drink, fixing and perfecting the design. Adding just a dab of politician, always knowing where to draw the line. Lining up for funds, but in addition, lining up a prominent commission. Otherwise, your perfect composition isn't going to get much exhibition. Art isn't easy. Every minor detail is a major decision. Have to keep things in scale. Have to hold to your vision. Every time I start to feel defensive, I remember lasers are expensive. What's a little cocktail conversation? If it's going to get you your foundation, leave it to a prominent commission, an exhibition in addition.
Art isn't easy, trying to make connections. Who understands it?
Difficult to evaluate.
Art isn't easy, trying to form collections. Always in transit.
Then when you have to collaborate.
Art isn't easy, any way you look at it.
George, honey. George, you have to meet Mr. Randolph.
Sure. Hello, Lee Randolph. I'm in charge of public relations here at the museum.
How do you
there
do?
There you are, George. Hi, Marie. Naomi Eisen.
Delighted. You know, you two made quite a stir around here tonight.
Hey, see, George, that technical foul-up didn't hurt our reception.
Yeah, there's a lot of opportunity for some fine press here.
Dot by dot, building up the image. Shut by shut. Keeping it a distance doesn't pay. Still, if you remember your objective, not give all your privacy away. A little bit of hype can be effective, as long as you can keep it in perspective. After all, without some recognition, no one's going to give you a commission. When it will cause a crack in the foundation, you'll have wasted all that conversation.
I am really sorry, George. I spoke to Naomi in great detail about how much electricity your synthesizer would use.
It is okay.
Laser was beautiful, George.
Yeah, it was, wasn't it? Now get yourself a drink and mingle.
George, there's one more thing I wanted to talk to you about. I was going to wait, but...
What?
I'll wait. I'm quitting.
Quitting?
I'm going back to NASA. There's just too much pressure in this line of work.
Don't do anything rash. You just gotta take it easy. You gotta sleep on this, and then we'll talk about it tomorrow.
Okay, George.
Art isn't easy.
Hey, it's the brain.
Even if you're smart.
A little technical screw-up
tonight.
You
think it's all together, and something falls apart.
I love the new machine, George.
Thanks, that means a lot to me.
Hey, we saw you talking to Redmond from Texas.
Yeah.
Did you get one of the commissions?
Oh, we talked about it, you guys?
Oh, her. My stuff is a little too inaccessible.
I love your work, Alex. I'll put in a good word for
you. He knows my work!
Hey, it is all politics, Alex. Maybe if you just lightened up once in a while.
Texas would be fun.
Art isn't easy. Overnight, you're a trend. You're the right combination. Then the trend's at an end. You suddenly last your sensation. So you should support the competition. Try to set aside your own ambition, even while you jockey for position. If
you feel a sense of coalition, then you never really stand alone. If you want your work to reach fruition, what you need's a link with your tradition. And of course, a prominent commission. Plus a little formal recognition so that you can go on exhibition. So that your work can go on exhibition.
There's the man of the hour.
There, hello. I read your piece on neo-expressionism.
Just what the world needs, another piece on neo-expressionism.
Well, I enjoyed it.
Good for you. Now, I'd no idea you might be related to 19th century France.
Oh, that is a cloudy ancestral line at best.
Well, I'm dying to meet your grandmother. It was fun seeing the two of you on stage with your invention. It added a certain humanity to the proceedings.
Humanity.
George. Chromolume number 7.
Be nice, George.
I was hoping it would be a series of 3, 4 at the most.
You have to pay a price, George.
We have been there before, you know.
You never suffer from a shortage of opinions, do you, Blair?
You never minded my opinions when they were in your favor.
They like to give
I
advice, George.
I tunneled your work from the beginning, you know that. You were really on to something
Don't
with these light machines
twice,
once.
George.
Now they're just becoming more and more about less and less.
I disagree.
Now, don't get me wrong. You're a talented guy. If you weren't, I wouldn't waste our time with my opinions, which you're capable of far more. Not that you couldn't succeed with chromolume after chromolume, but there are new discoveries to be made, George.
A new George. They tell you to the blue George. You know, or else you're through, George. And even if it's true, George, you do what you can do. Bit by bit, putting it together. Piece by piece, working up the vision night and day. All it takes is time and perseverance, with a little luck along the way. Putting in a personal appearance, gathering supporters and adherents.
But he combines all these different trends.
Mapping out the right configuration, starting with a suitable foundation.
He's an original.
Was. Lining up a prominent commission, and an exhibition in addition. Your little dab politician. Berlin's
up
to publication. What? Three hours out in the defense and preparation. Even if you don't have the suspicion that it's taking all your concentration. The art of making art is putting it together. Bit by bit, link by link, drink by drink, mink by mink. And that is the state of the art.
Dinner is served.
Lee, can I talk to you for a minute, please?
Just a minute. Excuse us. Could you please tell me, what is that square form up there?
That is a baby carriage.
Who told you that?
I'm sorry to butt in. I'm Blair Daniels. I've been waiting for the opportunity to tell you how much I enjoyed seeing you on stage.
Well, thank you, but my dear, that is not a baby carriage. That is Louis' waffle stove.
Waffle stove? But I've read all there is to read about this work. There's never been any mention of a waffle stove.
Well, I have a book, too. My mother's. It is a family legacy, as is this painting, and my mother often spoke of Louis' waffle stove.
Louis, yes, you mentioned him in your presentation.
Family, you know, it's all you really have.
You said that before.
I say it often.
Excuse us.
You know, Miss Daniels, there are only two worthwhile things to leave behind when you depart this world of ours. Children and art. Isn't that correct?
I never quite thought of it that way.
Do you know Elaine?
No, I don't believe we've met. Blair Daniels.
Oh, I've heard a lot about you.
Oh, yes.
Elaine and George were married once. I was so excited, I thought they might have a child. George and I are the only ones left, I'm afraid. I want George to have a child. Continue the line. You can understand that, can't you, Elaine?
Of course.
Are you married, Miss Daniels?
Awfully nice to have met you. Goodbye.
Elaine, honey, fix my chair so I can look at
George. I think Marie is a little too tired for the party. She seems to be slipping a bit.
I better take her back to the hotel.
No, I'll take her back. You stay.
No, it's a good excuse to leave early.
George, don't be silly. You're the toast of the party. You should feel wonderful.
Well, I don't feel wonderful.
Poor George. Well, it was a wonderful experience for Marie. I don't remember seeing her so happy. It was very good of you to include her.
Yes. She is something, isn't she?
Yes, she is.
George, grandmother.
Of course it is. I thought you were your father for a moment. Did I tell you who that was?
Of course. That is your mother.
That is correct. Isn't she beautiful? There she is, there she is, there she is, there she is. Mama is everywhere. He must have loved her so much.
Is she really in all those places, Marie?
This is our family. This is the lot. After I go, this is all that you've got, honey.
Let's not talk about that right now.
Wasn't she beautiful?
Yes.
You would have liked her. Mama did things no one had done. Mama was funny. Mama was fun. Mama spent money when she had none. Mama said, honey, mustn't be not so much do what you like as it is that you like what you do. Mama said, darling, don't make such a drama. A little less thinking, a little more feeling.
We not have this
I'm
discussion
just quoting
now.
Mama. The child is so sweet, and the girls are so rapturous. Isn't it lovely how artists can capture us?
Yes, it is.
You would have liked her. Honey, I'm wrong. You would have loved her. Mama enjoyed things. Mama was smart. See how she shimmers, I mean from the heart. I know, honey, you don't agree, but this is our family tree. Just wait till we're there and you see. Listen to me. Mama was smart. Listen to Mama. Bye, Mama.
Connect, George. Connect. Are you sure this is the best place for the chromo?
George, this is the largest clearing on La Grande Jatte.
Where's the still?
It has been built. It should be delivered tomorrow morning a couple of hours before the chromalome. I wanted it here today, but they don't make deliveries on Sunday.
Fresh water for the cooling system?
Yeah, we should be able to draw it from the Seine. As for the electricity...
Dennis, did you see this tree?
No.
Could be the one in the painting.
It could.
At least something is recognizable. Electricity.
Yeah, the wind generator's over here.
You have been efficient as always.
Thank you.
I'll miss working with you, Dennis.
I could recommend several capable people to help you with the Texas Commission.
I turned it down.
You what?
Dennis, why are you quitting?
I told you.
You know what you told me. Why are you really leaving?
George... I love the chromalomes, but I've helped you build the last five. I just need to do something different.
Well, I wish you would have told me that in the first place.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
What do you think I turned down the Texas Commission for? I don't want to do the same thing over and over again either.
Well, there are other things you could do.
I know. I just want to do something that I care about.
See, you brought the red book with you.
Yeah. Since Marie has died, I thought I would at least bring something of hers along.
Marie really wanted to make this trip.
I know.
Listen, I hope you don't mind. I took a look at the book. It's very interesting.
It's just a grammar book, Dennis.
Not that part. The notes in the back. Shall we wait for it to get dark? I'm not certain about the ambient light.
No. You go, Dennis. I'd like to be alone, actually.
You sure?
Yeah. I'll see you back at the hotel.
Hey, George. I look forward to seeing what you come up with next.
You're not the only one, Dennis. Charles has a book. Charles shows them his crayons. Marie has the ball of Charles. Good for Marie. Charles misses his ball. George misses Marie. George misses a lot. George is alone. George looks around. He sees the park. It is depressing. George looks ahead. George sees the dark. George feels afraid. Where are the people out strolling on Sunday? George looks within. George is adrift. George goes by guessing. George looks behind. He had a gift. When did it fade? You wanted people out strolling on Sunday. Sorry, Marie. See, George, remember how George used to be, stretching his vision in every direction. See, George attempting to see a connection when all he can see is maybe a tree, the family tree. Sorry, Marie. George is afraid. George sees the park. George sees it dying. George too may fade, leaving no mark, just passing through. Just like the people out strolling on Sunday. George looks around. George is alone, no use denying. George is aground. George has outgrown what he can do. George would have liked to see people out strolling on Sunday.
I must not recognize you without your beard.
You have my book.
Your book?
Yes.
It's a little difficult to understand.
Well, I was teaching myself. My writing got much better. I worked very hard. I made certain that Marie learned right away.
Marie.
It is good to see you. Not that I ever forgot you, George. You gave me so much.
What did I give you?
Oh, many things. You taught me about concentration. At first I thought that meant just being still. But I was to understand it meant much more. You meant to tell me to be where I was, not some place in the past or the future. I worried too much about tomorrow. I thought the world could be perfect. I was wrong.
What else?
Well, enough about me. What about you? Are you working on something new?
No, I'm not working on anything new.
That is not like you, George.
I've nothing to say.
You have many things.
Well, nothing that's not been said.
Said by you, though,
I do
George.
Not know where to go.
Nor did
I want to make things that count, things that will be new.
I did what I had to do.
What am I to do?
Move on. Stop worrying where you're going. Move on. If you could know where you're going, you've gone. Just keep moving on. So what? The choice may have been mistaken. The choosing was not. You have to move on. Look at what you want, not at where you are, not at what you'll be. Look at all the things you've done for me. Opened up my eyes. Taught me how to see. Notice every tree.
Understand the light.
Concentrate.
I want to explore the light. I want to know how to get through to something new, something of my own. Move on, move on.
Stop worrying if your vision is new. Let others make that decision they usually do. You keep moving on. Look at what you've done.
Something in the light, something in the sky, in the grass, up behind the tree.
Look at all the things you gave to me.
Things I haven't looked at till now. Flower in your hand. And your smile.
I would be so pleased.
And the color of your hair. And the way you catch the light. And the care and the feeling and the life moving on.
We've always been on together.
We will always belong.
Just keep moving on. Anything you do, let it come from you. Then it will be new. Give us more to see. What anyone thought. That upset me at the time because I wanted you to care what I thought.
I'm sure that I did.
I am sure that you did too.
Dot. Why did you write these words?
They are your words, George. The ones you muttered so often when you worked.
Order.
George, is that you?
Yes.
Well, tell me, is this place as you expected it?
What?
The park, of course.
Somewhat.
Go on.
Well. The greens are a little darker. And the sky is a little grayer. And there are mud tones in the water.
Well, yes, I suppose.
But the air seems rich and full of light.
Good.
Design. Tension. Composition. Balance. Light.
Dad, I cannot read this word.
Harmony.
So much love in his words. Forever with his cars. How George looks. He can look forever. What does he see? His eyes, so dark, so shiny, so careful, so excited. White, a blank page or canvas, his favorite. So many possibilities.
Thank you.
Thank you.